Piccolo, a little tiny flute.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Could I touch this?
Sure.
Oh, so you can change it.
I can change the color.
By pressing these buttons. When did you start to play the accordion?
I started when I was 6 years old. I saw one on television, on a program much like this, and told my dad that that's what I wanted to do.
And so you didn't start to play a big one like this, did you?
No, I started with a tiny little, called a 12-bass accordion. It's only about this big.
And then you played it and played it?
Played it, and then I got bigger, and so my accordion got bigger, and now
I mean, you had to buy a bigger accordion.
We had to keep getting a bigger one until we got to a full size. This is called a full size accordion, an adult accordion.
I see. And did you ever express your feelings with your accordion? I mean, when you were sad or angry or happy, did you ever play the way you felt?
Sure, that's one of the great things about it. Sometimes you can't tell somebody how you feel, but when you're alone, you can express it through your instrument. Mm. If I was sad, or if I was feeling angry, I might do something like. Then other times, I might be feeling on top of the world.
Fun. I would like very much to hear something. I know that you write music.
Yes,
you compose it. And I would like to hear something that you have written yourself.
That would be fun. Wonderful. When I was growing up, there weren't people who were writing much music for accordion, but I had a teacher who really encouraged me and said, create your own. If there's no music there, then you make the music yourself and play that, and that's what I've been doing. Mm. And I would like to play a little part of a piece called Scenes from a Mirage. A mirage is something that you see that's not really there. It's something that you see in your mind, in your imagination.
Oh, we like to think about imaginations here. We'll try to think of what you might be thinking of.
Okay.
So many images. I was just thinking of people walking along looking for one another.
I think when I wrote of it, I was thinking of people riding through a desert and they would see things through this kind of mist of sand. But other people see different things because we all have different experiences.
Yeah. You must have had some fine teachers.
I really did. I had an accordion teacher who taught me that you can do more with the accordion than people tell you that you normally can. Mm. And I was very pleased about that, and it's made a big difference to me.
Well, you certainly give a lot of pleasure to a lot of people.
Well, thank you, and it does a lot for me, too. But you know, Fred, it's a great pleasure visiting the neighborhood, but I really have to go because I have a concert and I still have to practice some more for it.
You practice every day?
I try to, especially when I have a concert.
Well, thank you for coming by.
Thank you for having me in the neighborhood.
We wish you well with this concert and all your concerts,
Guy. Thank you, Fred.
Bye.
Bye.
Mr. Klucevsek is such a fine artist. It's fun for me to be able to introduce you to people like that.